So it's St. Patrick's Day weekend and you're having a few drinks with friends. Don't make the incredibly stupid decision to get behind the wheel. If you do, you might see those blue and red lights in your rearview mirror and an officer pulling out one of these. Think you can beat the test? Forget it. Chemistry will land you in cuffs. We asked Corporal Mike Rose of the Prince George's County, Maryland Police to demonstrate an Alka-Sensor, one of the major types of breath testers in use today.
There's one cc breath sample that is taken by the instrument. It is placed into where there's what's called a fuel cell. This fuel cell, all it does is react with alcohol. There's an electrical discharge that'll take place from that fuel cell. And there's a direct proportion, depending upon the amount of alcohol that's in the breath sample, to how much electricity will come out.
But how do I know it's accurate, your drunk self is saying? The breath testers are calibrated with a gas mix that mimics someone blowing a .08, so there's very little guessing involved. These field units are accurate enough where a police officer can confirm that you probably shouldn't be behind the wheel, at which point they'll bring you into the station for a breath test with a full-sized, higher accuracy unit. But how does your breath give away how much alcohol is in your body?
With your breath, there's a direct correlation between the percentage of alcohol that's in your blood and the breath that's expelled. That's a 2100:1 ratio. We can measure the amount of the air, and the air is gonna have the same proportion of alcohol in the air that's coming back out as was in the blood that's flowing through your body.
It turns out that once ethanol, the alcohol found in beer, wine, and liquor, is absorbed by your stomach and moves through your liver and bloodstream, a tiny fraction of it makes its way to your lungs. And even if you are just under the legal limit, chances are you won't pass a field sobriety test. Don't try to wait it out either. Your body can only metabolize about 3/4 of one regular drink per hour, so you'll be waiting a while if you're trying to sober up. So drink your green beer, have a good time, but remember the bottom line. Bring a designated driver that will blow one of these, so you don't end up in one of these. That's it for this week. Once you get rid of that hangover, which by the way you can learn about here, why not subscribe to get more chemistry fun from ACS each week?